The world that Ernest J. Gaines writes about often has, as its source and center, a feeling for life in a place called the Quarters, that area of a plantation once set aside for the housing of slaves. Most men and women who lived in that world never expected to leave it. Even the dead stayed interred in the Quarters' own tiny cemeteries. More than 70 years after slavery was legally abolished, the concept of the Quarters was still very much alive as housing for field hands and sharecroppers. Ernest Gaines knows because he was born in just such surroundings. The year was 1933. The place was called River Lake Plantation in Oscar, Louisiana. He worked the same fields his parents had worked when they were young, and his grandparents and great-grandparents before them. But then, when he was 15 years old, Ernest left the Quarters. He got out, and he began to write about that world. His early work reached only a small audience, but then he published a novel about a 110-year-old black woman called The Autobiography of Miss Jane Pittman, and it brought him worldwide recognition. In Miss Jane, as well as in his other works, he writes of the search for self-respect and dignity that every person, every child especially, must undertake. The story we're about to see is called The Sky is Gray. It's about a young boy and his mother who take a simple yet momentous journey from the Quarters into town on one cold winter day in the early 1940s. It's a day that will bring some powerful lessons to our young hero.
Still hurting, huh? You can't talk? You ain't told nobody? I sure will tell somebody. My tooth was hurting me, I sure will tell somebody.
Your mama be through cutting everything by the time you get there. You too, Todd. Where are you at?
James. How long your teeth been hurting you?
I ain't got no toothache.
Whose jaw was you holding last night? Go on in there and get you some aspirin. Jug it down there. Wrap it up in some cotton first.
Through my most grievous fault. How you feeling?
Same.
Through the power of the Holy Ghost, through him, with him, in the name of the Father and the Son. Still hurting?
Yes, sir.
What kind of prayers you praying, boy?
Baptist.
Oh, no wonder that tooth is still killing him. I'm going one way and he's pulling another.
Mm-hmm.
Boy, don't you know any Catholic prayers?
I know Hail Mary.
Mm-hmm. Well, you better start saying them.
Yes, sir. Hail Mary, full of grace.
The Lord is with thee. Blessed art thou amongst women, and blessed is the fruit of thy womb, Jesus. How's that?
Stop. Don't hurt no more.
James, come here. You done caught a couple of birds in your trap.
Oh, Mama, can I keep him? Me and Ty could train him, and I could raise him, Mama.
Roseberry, get me a fork.
Ty.
Make a fine meal, Octavian.
I got it. I got it, honey.
Can't.
James, take this fork.
Please, Mama, I can't kill him.
Take this fork, James. Get him out of there.
I can't, Mama.
Get him out of there, James. Give it here. swan. Get all of them. Please, Mama. I'll do anything, but don't make me do this.
James, get him out of there. Get him out, James. Get him out.
Octavia, explain to the child. Don't just beat him. Explain to him.
James, get him out.
James, my boy, you did a good job.
Sure did.
Yep, a pretty good job. I needed meat.
How you feel?
James, tomorrow we go into town.
But it ain't hurt me no more, Mama. See? I don't need anything wrong. I can get the work done.
You're going to town tomorrow. I'm tired. Going to bed. Night, y'all. You and Ty don't be too far behind me, James.
That boy is just like his daddy. It's a damn shame the way they took him away and ain't even give Octavia enough to help with them children. But that's the army for you. If they didn't get me and they ain't ever gonna get me.
Shh. You're gonna wake them up. Besides, they don't need to hear that.
Well, it's the God's truth. She's working out in them fields, rain or shine, trying to make ends meet. That it just ain't right. A sweet little thing like you shouldn't have to mess herself up about working in them fields.
All right. All right. But one day, they gonna find out.
Well, all we can do is what we doing. Rest is in his hands. Ain't for us to question.
Yep, I guess you're right. Well, now, sugar, let's talk about me and you.
I wish you'd just be quiet.
All right, I'll be quiet. I ain't saying nothing, honey.
Oh, that's a mess.
I got enough to go and come back. $1.50, Ab's tooth pull, nickel for me to go, a nickel for him, dime to come back, got 50 cents left. Guess I could get a little piece of salt meat with that.
Oh, sure can use it. White beans and no salt meat just ain't white beans.
Sure ain't. Better get ready. We can catch the noon bus and still work the fields this afternoon.
Thank you.
Is that your friend in there?
That's my friend.
John Lee Williams?
Who's seeing the dentist? What's his name?
I don't want to go! No!
Man, I thought they was killing you in there. Howling like a pig under a gate.
Why the Lord let that child suffer like that?
It's not for us to question.
Sometimes, maybe we should.
I know definitely we shouldn't.
Why?
Why anything?
Why he let us poor folks suffer the most? I don't understand it.
Best not to try. He works in mysterious ways as wonders to perform.
We should question and question. Question everything.
No! No!
Maybe you've explained what you mean.
I meant what I said. Question everything.
Me and this lady was talking about God.
Question him too.
Wait a minute. Just wait a minute.
Show me one reason to believe in the existence of a God.
My heart tells me.
My heart tells me. My heart pumps blood throughout my body, nothing else. We're supposed to question everything. Freedom, liberty, God, white, colored. What do all those words mean?
It's what we're educating them for. To be mad at the world.
You ain't educating me. Now, I wash dishes at night so I can go to school in the day. Because I ask questions, you call me mad.
I'm sorry for you.
You feel sorry for yourself because a white man told you to believe in God. And why? To keep you ignorant so he can keep his foot on your neck.
So now I's ignorant, too.
Yeah, you ignorant.
Get up, boy.
You forgot the other cheek. Ain't changed a thing.
I feel sorry for you. Y'all excuse me. I come back some other time.
They got some books over there, Mama. Want to read one of them? Can I? You really don't believe in God?
No.
Why?
Because the wind is pink.
That's a good one.
Yes, sir. That's a good one.
You don't believe the wind is pink?
Sure I do, honey. Sure I do. What color is grass?
Grass? Grass is black. You don't believe it.
Grass is green. It was green yesterday. It's green today. And it is going to be green tomorrow.
Prove it's green.
Oh, it's not going to come to that, is it?
Words mean nothing. One no more than the other. Now, it's green because someone told you it's green. If they told you it was black, you believe that. Action is the only thing. Doing. Words mean nothing.
I didn't agree with that preacher before, but now I don't know. When somebody say that grass is black, either he's a lunatic or something is wrong.
Prove to me it's green.
It's green because people say it's green.
The same people says you're a citizen.
Well, I think I'm a citizen.
Citizens have rights. Name me one right you have. One right granted by the Constitution you can exercise in Bayonne.
Things is changing.
Cause we thinking with our head, not our hearts.
Are the new models all like you?
I hope not, ma'am. I don't believe in your gods. I was born too late. Now let's hope your children have a better chance than me. I don't believe in anything. For me, the wind is pink and grass is black.
The doctor will not be seeing any more patients till 1 o'clock this afternoon.
Nurse, I've got to go back to the fields this afternoon.
The doctor's treating his last patient now.
Can I at least speak to the doctor?
I'm his nurse.
My little boy's sick. His tooth's almost killing him.
This afternoon.
I'm home. Make water?
No, ma'am.
James, keep your eyes in front. Got any axe handles?
Yeah.
Peut-être la semaine qui vient quand tu vas aller au bar.
Oh, oui, ça va bien.
Ça va bien.
Ça va bien.
Tu es donc.
Oh, oui.
Moi, tu crois que tu es allé à un morceau comme ça, là, je vais mourir ça.
Passe-partout aussi.
Ça, c'est juste.
Ton filet passe-partout.
Et quand? Également.
Il y a la semaine passée.
Je vais faire la radio. Et.
Comment pour bien, homme?
Son homme fait mal.
James?
C'est pas bon, non?
C'est pas bon,
non? Non, c'est pas beaucoup bon.
Walk back or you rather don't eat and ride.
I am hungry.
Come on.
I ain't hungry, Mama.
Got to pay him something for the heat. A couple of those cakes. Coffee and the milk, please.
I can't eat all this, Mama.
Watch this.
Oh, yeah, okay, we'll see.
Keep your eyes on your plate.
Forever, the touch that lives on. When we're
I'll gut you from your nabo to your throat. Come on.
You some pimp, yes, sir. You a pimp, all right. Yes, sirree. You don't have to leave, honey.
Just finished.
Y'all must be cold then.
We're heading for the dentist. We'll warm up when we get there.
Which dentist? Mr. Bassey?
Yes, ma'am.
Come on in then. I'll telephone and tell him y'all come. Come on. Yes, Honest?
Did you see him?
They're here, standing in front of me.
Now you can stay inside.
I saw you all each time you went by. I went out to catch you, but you was gone.
We went back of town.
Did you eat?
Yes, ma'am.
There's food in the kitchen. I've been keeping it warm.
We don't take no handouts.
I'm not handing out anything. I need my garbage moved to the front. Ernest has a bad cold. He can't go out.
James will move it for you.
Not unless you eat. I'm old, but I got my pride too, you know. Come into the kitchen. Not you, boy. You have to move the cans.
Elena.
Yes, Honest?
Are you going out there again?
I must show the boy where the garbage is.
Keep your shawl on.
Come on, boy. Put it on the sidewalk and come back for the other one.
Thank you.
dinner?
Yes, Ernest.
Are they eating?
Yes.
Good. Now you'll stay inside.
Talk to Dr. Bassett's nurse. He'll take you just as soon as you get there.
Thank you, ma'am.
Perfectly all right. Which one is it? You're not afraid, are you?
No, ma'am.
That's a good boy. Dr. Bassett won't hurt you. Thank you.
Thank you.
Elena, are they leaving?
Yes, Ernest.
Tell them I said goodbye.
They can hear you, Ernest.
Bye, mother and son. May God be with you.
Goodbye.
Bye.
You sell salt meat?
Yes.
Give me 2 bits worth. That isn't very much salt meat.
It's all I have. That's an awful lot of meat for a quarter.
I've been selling salt meat behind this counter for 25 years. I think I know what I'm doing.
You got a scale there, weigh it.
You telling me how to run my business?
Thank you very much for the food. James?
Just a minute.
Your kindness will never be forgotten. James?
Jane, turn that collar right back down.
You're not a bum. You're a man.